Hello, my quilting friends. My name is Leah Day, and in this video, I want to teach you how to batch import files into your Quilter's Creative Touch. This is how we get files that we buy from other sites into our QCT program. So the first thing is going to be to purchase your designs and download them. And I like to download them onto a little flash drive like this. So I already have my compressed zip folder on this little flash drive here. And let's see here, let's go into the flash drive. So here you can see, this is all the different folders and files that I have on this flash drive. And here I have a zipped file of maximized feather blocks. Now a zip file is how your designs are going to arrive, especially if you buy a collection, because they have to be all combined together. And that is how it's going to arrive, as a zipped file. So you're gonna go up here into extract, and then you're gonna click extract all. And I want it to stay on my D drive as maximized feather blocks. And you could always change this. You could put this on your desktop, but it's really gonna be easiest to import into QCT if it stays in your little flash drive here. So we're gonna click extract, and then it'll extract it. And that will be a new folder within that little drive. So here you can see my D drive, and then there's maximized feather blocks. Now your compressed folder, you can actually delete that just so you don't get confused by it, because that compressed folder, you no longer need it. You've already extracted it. So I'm gonna go here and tap delete and send that to my trash can. All right, so that's really the steps. You want to download your compressed folder into a little flash drive and then extract your files. And so now it's time to actually open QCT. And as you can tell, I don't have this attached to my long arm. I'm in simulation mode, so I'm gonna continue in simulation mode. And I really think that this is the easiest way to import your designs. So I'm going to continue simulating. I'm gonna say yes, and we're gonna click select and sew. Now, because we're simulating, we have to set our safe area. And I'm just gonna type this in, 50 by 15. It really doesn't matter what these numbers are. It just sets a nice safe area so that way we can have something to play with. All right, so I'm just gonna select any design because it's really not important, these designs on this page. What's important is to get to the next page. So I'm just gonna select this 1E design and click open. And this gets us to this page. And this is important because all we need is this button up here in the corner, and that's plugins. So I'm gonna tap plugins, and I'm gonna click batch import. All right, so now this is what's important. We want to import our designs, and we're gonna select new drive. And this is what makes it so much easier to import from a flash drive, because here it is, right here. We can just tap on that, and here's just these few folders to work with, right? If we did it the other way, if we had this on our desktop, we'd have to go through lots of different folders in order to get where we wanted to go. So I am going to tap on maximize feather blocks. There we go. It's going to open that folder. And then now here are all of my QLI files. That is the type of file that you want, QLI files. You can also import all of these different ones down here. You can see CMD, CQP, CSV, DXF, HQF, QData, QLI, SSD, TAP, TXT, and XY. But for your best, you know, best purposes, kind of the advice from Grace Company is either QCP or QLI files. So I'm gonna come down here and tap multi, and I'm gonna be able to tap on all of these and get all 12 selected at once. And it doesn't matter however many you have in the set that you have purchased. This is a batch import, so we can import them all at once. We're gonna tap import, and you can see it all coming in, and they're gonna go one at a time until you get all 12 in, and then it will give you a little success. There we go, batch import process complete. Your imported patterns are in the pattern slash batch folder. Alrighty, so click okay, and then no, we don't wanna batch import more patterns. All right, so I'm gonna go back. We're going to click select pattern. We're gonna go into our patterns folder, and we're going to open up our batch. And here you can see all of our pretty patterns to play with. So yet again, I'm going to tap multi because I want to select these and I want to get them moved into another folder because I don't want to leave them in my batch folder. We're actually going, let's back up one step and let's actually make the folder first for them to go into. So I'm going to tap new and I'm going to type in the folder name. And I actually have a keyboard here attached to my tablet, but if you don't have a keyboard attached, of course, this will pop up and you can always type this in on your screen. So the new folder name, I'm going to do 01 feather blocks. Okay. And click okay. So there we go. I've got a new folder to put these designs in. So I'm going to double click on my batch folder. I'm going to have multi-selected and I could always just say all, and that makes it a little easier, right? I don't have to tap on every single one. So now I'm going to hit cut. Are you sure you want to cut all these files? What does cutting mean? Cutting means that I'm going to select all of them and cut them out of the folder. They're going to be deleted out of this folder so that I can paste them into another folder. So I'm going to say yes. Now the most important thing is don't do anything else until you get these pasted into your proper folder, because otherwise you might lose them. So here we go. We're going to tap on patterns. We're going to go into that new folder we just created, and then we're going to tap paste, and there they all are. So there we go. That is how you bring in all of your files. And as you can see, I can click on patterns and I now have this new folder where all of these designs are going to live on my computer from now on. And I can always find them within that folder within QCT. So I can always select on one of these, open it up and get started quilting it. So this is really exciting. It allows you to be able to purchase designs, import them into your computer, and really expand your abilities with Quilter's creative touch. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you would like to find these pretty maximized feather blocks, you can find this collection on my website at leahday.com/maxfeather.